I'm Julian Heller. I'm here outside Northern Secondary School, which is our local neighborhood high school. My three children went here and had a great time and got a great education. But we're here today to see what the state of the facilities is and compare it to some private schools nearby. We're in the Toronto District School Board area in the city of Toronto, and we're at Mount Pleasant and Eglinton. Premier Kathleen Wynne lives a few blocks that way, and so we're going to take a little drive this morning to see what we can see in terms of public and private schools and see what the differences are, and maybe that'll be a little message as to what we want all children in Ontario to be able to enjoy when they're at high school in the province. So let's see what we can find, and I look forward to this little journey. We're now behind Northern Secondary School at the home of the Northern Red Knights, and the good part of the story is that a few years ago the school community, together with some maintenance funds from the school board and some contributions from developers via a mechanism under the municipal legislation, managed to put together enough money to create this beautiful new AstroTurf field. And it is really lovely, and as you can see behind me, there are students and the teams use it. The only problem is it's the 75-cent solution, unfortunately, because they ran out of money before they could put in the end zones. So we'll take a look at the end zones, which are natural grass, and that's actually, I think, a health hazard for players, but most of the field is AstroTurf. And of course, we see here grass growing in the concrete lanes because there wasn't enough money to put in a new running track. The beautiful stands where students come to watch their teams and cheer them on, that's a great set of stands, but if you take a closer look, the seats haven't been painted in a number of years.
It is a bit unfortunate to have end zones that are 5-yard end zones when the space is available. We have the opportunity to do more. It just feels as though it was sort of partially done.
Okay, well, that was Northern Secondary School. Now we're just going to hop in the car and drive a few minutes south on Mount Pleasant to Greenwood, which is a private school, and see what they got going there. Great. Okay, we've traveled kilometers south from a Northern Secondary School where we just were. We're now in front of Greenwood School, which is a private co-ed school, grade 7 to 12, about 430 students. Started in about 2002, and according to the school website, the school raised $20 million in the first 5 years of its existence. And now there's a big construction project going on to add new facilities, which I'm sure all of the students will enjoy. And according to the school website, which I'll just read, as a charity registered with Canada Revenue Agency, the school distributes tax receipts for donations and has established a separate foundation to manage the school's endowment. Close quote. So what that means is that through the tax system, you and I are basically subsidizing this great facility for a private school 1 kilometer down the road from the public school whose facilities we just saw, and we'll see more other public schools later on in this trip down Mount Pleasant Road. Well, we've traveled 3 kilometers down Mount Pleasant, and we're now standing outside Branksome Hall, a private girls' school founded in 1903. There are about 900 students, and there are a lot of promotional items around, billboards, signs on street lamps, and so forth. Reach for the top, they've raised $15 million. Over here, they say, girls lift themselves up, we lift them higher, be remarkable. Being remarkable is the tagline on the Athletics and Wellness Center behind me. According to McLean's magazine, which came out in September, $41 million was spent to build this beautiful facility, a 68,000 square feet athletic and wellness center. It has two saltwater pools, it has a yoga studio, it has a number of other exercise and dance facilities. And wouldn't it be great if all of the students in Toronto and Ontario had the ability to develop and reach their potential in environments as wonderful as these. We're now standing behind Jarvis Collegiate, a high school in downtown Toronto. We just drove a little bit down from Branksome Hall, and let's see what is back here. Through the fence, because we can't get access right now, we see a field, but there's a rather large dirt patch right in the middle, and even though the sprinklers came on a few minutes ago, good luck with that, because that's going to turn into mud. There are two goalposts, but I would say they're about 50 yards apart, which of course is far short of the regulation size for either a soccer or football field. There looks to be the remnants of a baseball infield, but there's no backstop, there's no bases, and the basketball backboards, of course, have no rims or nets, so hard to know how to play basketball with that configuration. So the grass is growing in between the concrete running track, so a little bit short, I would suggest, of what we would want to give to our high school students to give them the best opportunities, and certainly a far cry from some of the private schools that we saw up the road. So the end of our trip down Mount Pleasant onto Jarvis Street, now downtown Toronto. Jarvis Collegiate, oldest public secondary school in Ontario, founded in 1807. But you've seen the difference in the facilities between the public and the private schools on our tour down this one stretch of downtown Toronto. And so the rest is up to you, Ontario. Students, parents, residents, citizens, politicians, what is it that we want to do for our students now that we've seen the differences in the opportunities that students have in this one little part of the province? The rest is up to you. Thanks for coming along.